Barakatuh. Children, today let us study in history a very good topic that is called the Mauryan Empire. So in this Mauryan Empire, we are going to study about who are the rulers, what are the places they conquered, how they became famous. Before starting to the topic, children, you have to take your atlas, open the atlas book, India map. In that you are going to find out where does this Magadha come and the places which is say. That one you are going to find out, okay? Let us begin the topic. The Mauryan Empire, we are going to learn about this. So in this topic we are going to study about the place called Magadha. This is one of the most powerful kingdom in India. And this kingdom, it was not only one kingdom, there were 16 kingdoms. So this Magadha got the title as Mahajanapadas. Do you know which are the 16 kingdoms? See, I'll say you which are those. Like Kasi, Kosala, Anga, Magadha, Vaji, Mala, Chidi, Vatsa, Kuru, Panchala, many more. So among all this, so Magadha was one of the powerful kingdoms. So it has got the title called Mahajanapadas. Okay, children? And who was the ruler? The ruler was called Dhanananda. He was not so popular, he was not so famous, but he was having enormous wealth. And to bring out the popularity, he started to do welfare of the people. So after this Dhanananda, the ruler, we'll study in Magadha dynasty, who was a very popular and famous prime minister. He's called Chanakya or Kautilya. He is also known as Vishnugupta. Who? Chanakya. So let us have a few points on Chanakya. Chanakya was an ancient Indian teacher. He was a philosopher, economist, jurist, and social advisor, royal advisor. So he is traditionally identified as Kautilya or Vishnugupta. Who? Chanakya. Chanakya, he assisted in the sense here the first empire that is called Mauryan Empire. In the Mauryan Empire, Chandragupta, he's very popular ruler in the Mauryan dynasty, Chandragupta. So Kautilya or the Chanakya, the first Mauryan emperor, Chandragupta, in his rise, he supported for whom? Chandragupta. He is widely credited for having a vital role in the history, that is to the Mauryan Empire. The establishment of the Mauryan Empire, Chanakya, he served as the chief advisor to both emperor, that is Chandragupta, and his son called Bindusara. So without him, Chandragupta was not becoming a popular ruler in the dynasty. Okay, children? So this Chanakya, he is a very great advisor to Chandragupta. This Chandragupta always depended on Chanakya. Whatever he want to take a suggestions and everything, he takes from Chanakya. So with the help of him, Chanakya, Chandragupta, he raised an army and attacked a place called Pataliputra. And in that, the ruler was called Dhanananda. Dhanananda was overthrown and he was killed. Who killed Dhanananda? Chandragupta, with the advisor and the support of Chanakya. And from there, the Mauryan Empire, the dynasty, it is the first and great dynasty in India. So the main information about the Mauryan period, so in this Mauryan period, a very well-known ambassador, he is called Megasthenes. He visited India and composed a book that is called Indica. And Arthashastra means economics. This was composed by Chanakya or Kautilya. And also the rock edicts of Ashoka and the coins of the Mauryan Empire. Now let us study how the rise of the Mauryan Empire began. Chandragupta, he was the first ruler of the Mauryan dynasty. His accession to the throne of the Magadha that took place in the year 320 BC. BC means before Christ. Magadha that took place in 324 BC. BC means before Christ. So then he fought with a very popular person is called Seleucus. So Chandragupta fought with Seleucus. The strap behind Alexander, Macedonia, and while returning from the Greece in the sense here. So you'll study this in the next topic, children, in the next higher classes about Seleucus Nicator. So here, children, Seleucus Nicator, the satrap that left behind by Alexander of Macedonia before his return to Greece and inflicted a crushing defeat on him. That is for whom? That is to Alexander. And Seleucus, he conquered many places and later he don't have any choice. So Seleucus, he was forced to surrender. Who said that one? That is Chandragupta. He also, he don't have any options in front of Chandragupta. And later Seleucus, he gave his daughter in marriage to Chandragupta. And Chandragupta, he allowed a great ambassador. So Chandragupta, he granted a permission for a Greek ambassador. He was called Megasthenes. This Megasthenes, he stayed in the court of Chandragupta, that is at a place called Pataliputra. And Megasthenes, he composed a book called Indica, that is an autobiography on Chandragupta. This was composed by Megasthenes. Okay. So now let us study about Chandragupta's son. He is called Bindusara. Bindusara. So after 25 years of ruling, that is the Chandragupta, his son came to power. He is called Bindusara. Where did this Chandragupta go? Chandragupta, he left his dynasty and he followed, embraced the religion that is called Jainism, and he handed over the dynasty to his son called Bindusara. Bindusara, he was a very efficient ruler. He extended the empire, means he enlarged the empire as south as Mysore. And Bindusara, he ruled almost the whole India, the region that is called the Kalinga, that comes under Odisha. The kingdom that is extreme to the south, it's not a part of empire. So when we see, can you observe the map, children, here? The purple color. So this hill, the places were conquered during the rule of Mauryan Empire, and to the below, that is to the south, it is left up. In the sense here, they didn't extend the empire to south. So this was the holding position of the empire till here Bindusara conquered the places. Bindusara, he maintained a very good relation with the Greeks and the rulers, with the Greeks and the rulers of Syria and Egypt.